The Lower Rio Grande Valley is found nowhere else in the United States. It's a very special place.
Refuge is 35 years old or so, which is pretty young by refuge standards. When the refuge was established, the motivation behind it was that upwards of 95% of the native vegetation had been removed for agriculture and urbanization.
The area was so highly fragmented that somebody needed to provide restoration efforts so wildlife would have safe passage between one tract of land to another one.
So the importance of being successful in connecting the dots and to create the wildlife corridor was that that will ultimately benefit the ocelot and the other vulnerable species. American Forest has been supporting our reforestation efforts since 1997, and they've helped reimburse us for seedlings for upwards of 1.5 million trees.
We're at Santa Ana National Wildlife Refuge, where just down the road about a mile is our Marinoff nursery, where we grow about 100,000 seedlings per year. We grow them in seedling bands, which are biodegradable plant containers that we can plant directly in the ground. It saves us a lot of time and labor.
It's actually a member of the citrus family. Do you smell the leaf here?
By the fall, they've grown to around 6 to 12 inches and they're ready to plant in the ground.
Our rate of restoration totally hinges on the availability of the native seedlings. And so American Forest has helped us increase our restoration capabilities by making funding available to help buy seedlings.
It's a really good working partnership that helps restore a lot of land for wildlife.
Visitation here is around 150,000 visitors a year. People come from all over the world to see rare birds that you can't see anywhere else in the United States.
I'm Benton Bassam, a friend of Santa Ana forever. Started birding here in 1969. Santa Ana has always had a real good list of birds, and I can't think of a single species that's occurred here that I haven't seen.
People understand the relationship of forest, habitat, and wildlife and how they're interrelated.
He likes you.
Once they sort of create that connection to nature, they'll be able to care and perhaps help preserve it in the future.
I hope we'll actually succeed in connecting the dots of habitat on the valley, and we'll see ocelots on the refuge again, you know, in fair numbers in the future.